She came to Toronto with her husband and her baby, looking for the good life, streets all paved with gold, freedom of expression and a chicken in the pot. She hoped she wouldn't mind the legendary cold. He went into language school to learn a little English. They told her he'd need it more than she ever will. As soon as she had learned to say hello, goodbye, and thank you, she was working on Spadina in a textile mill.
Sewing machines, sewing machines, is that what freedom means? Sewing machines, sewing machines, is that what freedom means?
She gets up at 5 and puts the house in order, makes the lunch and breakfast, takes the children to her neighbor. 5 to 8 she clocks and goes to her machine. Then it's 13 hours of hard, hard labor. He doesn't mind her working, but he doesn't help at home. Men didn't do that in the old country. And he goes out with friends, his wife's no longer fun. She's always too tired to love him properly.
Sewing machines, sewing machines, is that what freedom means? Sewing machines, sewing machines, is that what freedom means?
Whatever happened to my Maria, the shiny-haired girl with the sparkling eyes? I brought her here to this new land of plenty, but she just won't Canadianize. She doesn't learn English like the children and me. She's always too tired, but I think she's lazy. Oh, whatever happened to my Maria? I miss the light in her eyes. The factory is filthy, the wages are the lowest. Sometimes talk of a union makes a stir, but the boss just says, do you want to be deported? She doesn't understand that he can't do that to her. And so she works her life away without too much complaint. After all, she got here one of the lucky ones. She sacrifices dignity, youth, health, and love to make a decent future for her daughter and her son.
Sewing machines, sewing machines, is that what freedom means? Sewing machines, is that